was the king of the two-finger push-up and the one-inch punch. And his mastery of the deadly nunchuckers has yet to be surpassed. But nearly four decades after his death, Bruce Lee is remembered as a true ambassador of Asia.
It creates a positive image for anyone who's open to Bruce Lee and his idea and how much he had to go through life to conquer and to overrule the stereotypes that the Asians would have in the movies and how much he fought up against that to make a really intelligent character.
His introduction of Kung Fu to the West, both as a teacher and as the star of films like Fist of Fury and Enter the Dragon, ensured Bruce Lee a legacy that would extend way beyond his tragic death at the age of 32. As he himself once said, the key to immortality is first living a life worth remembering. That life was remembered in 2008 in a 50-part TV series called The Legend of Bruce Lee, and was aired in the lead-up to the Beijing Olympics to serve as inspiration to a new generation of Chinese athletes.
怎么在某一方面再牛，哐一脚给你干开，这个东西可能是要通过李小龙身上学到的，因为中国人太会忍，和谐当中也得要有一些英雄气概。
As much a philosopher as he was a fighter, the former child actor who learned to defend himself in the gangland wars of Hong Kong offered his fans and disciples great lessons in their approach to life. Among his most famous quotes is, "I always learn something, and that is to always be yourself. And to express yourself, to have faith in yourself. Do not go out and look for a successful personality and duplicate him." In acknowledgement of the fact that there will only ever be one Bruce Lee, both Bosnia and Hong Kong chose to mark what would have been his 65th birthday to unveil bronze statues of the star. At the Hong Kong ceremony, his brother and sister played guests of honor, as Bruce's trademark howl was played over speakers to a crowd that had gathered from as far away as Africa and Britain to pay tribute to their hero.